everybody. Virtual learning, here we are. So I hope many of you are enjoying your time home. I know it's gonna be a lot different than what it typically would be, being here, being present, as you see. I'm all alone. So this is what I hope you can do. Number one, pay careful attention to the weekly diary. Now I'm gonna send each one of you a document. You know this document if you know me. It requires that you take a look at it, and day by day, what you have to do is input information specific to you as per the document. How many hours did you sleep? What specifically did you eat for breakfast, for snacks, for lunch, for snacks, for dinner, for snacks? How much water did you drink specifically? It's important that you have specific information on the data sheet, because then what we'll be able to do is extract that data later on. We'll be able to compare and contrast it month by month. If you can take it a step further, do this work. I apologize for the noise. As you know, the heating element makes one noise. Something's going on up there, some type of vibration. I hope you were able to hear this well enough. In the event that you did not, I'll make sure that I type all this out, put it in a Google Doc, and attach it to your class. The last thing, try to get a minimum of 30 minutes. Continuous exercise each day. Even though our classes are only going to be 25 minutes in length, you're going to need that 30 minutes based on the American Heart Association's recommendation for cardiovascular exercise. Personally, need 25 minutes for class time, extended to get that 30. If you want to get the most out of yourself, instead of elongating that 30-minute time, let's say 45 or 60 minutes, do an AM session in the morning, 25, 30 minutes. Do a PM session in the afternoon, early evening, or evening, 25, 30 minutes. That way you set up an interval so your metabolic engine, or the process that works really hard to delegate the responsibility of calories within your body as you're awake and asleep, uses the optimal amount. That way we won't store fat, we'll just have usable, tangible energy. Okay, today's warm-up started right now. Take your hips and throw an imaginary line through your knees into your feet. Put the weight onto your heels. Sides of your feet. Stay off your toes. Stay off the balls of your feet. Stand straight up. Standing straight up accentuates postural development. We are not meant to sit down. We are meant to move. Therefore, the more we sit, the more our posture comes out to a natural alignment. Ergonomics, or the study of proper bodily alignment, is extremely important because the way we stand and the way we sit becomes a habit, and our bodies learn those habits. These are kinesthetic habits, or body by doing demonstration habits. So that's about 1 minute of time. That's about what we want to do. Now, standing straight up, holding vertebral stability, turn the head left, which is your right, my right, which is your left, and each one of these exercises is dynamic in nature, which means we're moving, we're not holding positions. Moving stretches, or dynamic stretches, improve blood flow, which in turn enhances circulation, which in turn promotes healing. And the healing promotes growth. So as you see, it's a general flow that really only serves to help as long as we designate the time to do as such. I'm going to estimate that I'm going to get each one of these dynamic stretches for a minute. If you find yourself becoming dizzy during this exercise, just stand straight up. We'll do another half rep. Now that was cervical rotation left and right. This is cervical flexion, cervical extension. So you just want to be nice, slow, chin to sternum, and then you want the lower portion of your head to touch the upper portion of your back. Just slow, rhythmic, ergonomic, which again just means body correct, dynamic stretch. Again, standing straight up, really focusing on the necessary movement and eliminating everything that which we don't need. Let's come back to the middle. Now, lateral flexion left, which is your right. Lateral flexion right, which is your left. Lateral flexion is our weak point as a species in terms of movement, strength, flexibility, and stamina. So a mistake would be to try to put your ear to your shoulder. It's not going to happen. Do not try it. Instead, maintain your vertebral stability, stand straight up, and just laterally flex. As you can see, my range of motion is probably something like 4 or 6 inches. Yours could be better, yours could be a little less. Most important, find the adequate range that makes you feel stretch is taking place. Return to the middle, repeat to the other side. Back to the middle. Now what we're going to do is a roll. So gently roll your head on its axis. This is definitely an exercise that you can become dizzy doing if your neck or cervical region is out of alignment. If that's the case for you, obviously stop and go see a chiropractor. Physical education teachers do not have the ability to align the spine. Once you get back to the middle, what I want you to do is flex and roll the other way. Pay careful attention to how slowly I'm doing this. It's very deliberate. Many of you may wake up with a stiff neck in the morning. That could be for a variety of reasons. Back to the middle. Shoulder shrug up. Back, around, down, up, back, around, down, up. And I'm just going to keep going. Breathe. Now breathe with me. Let your arms hang. Keep the body weight on the balls. All the balls of the feet, off the toes, onto the heels. Get this elevation. The muscle that's responsible for helping us to elevate the shoulder girdle is levator scapula. Levator kind of sounds like elevator. A little bit. One more. So again, our cue is up, around, and down. Now, relaxing, standing straight up. We're going to go back, up, around. So it's a forward circle. Back, up, around. Breathe with me. Arms out, palms down, small circles forward. Again, standing straight up, keeping breath as natural as possible. Maybe you might try to catch your breath per se. Just keep it natural. If you feel tired, if you feel dizzy, if you feel faint, take a break, pause the video, come back later. If you feel okay, well, keep going, right? That's what we're trying to do, a little bigger. We're trying to take things that we do on a typical daily basis, and we're gonna do them a little bit better, and we're gonna do them a little bit more often. This video is gonna be your video for the week, so week one video. That's what we're gonna do, bigger. You wanna get yourself into a routine, bigger. Now let's stay here now. Oh, class is not over, everyone. I guess I didn't time that well. All right, now watch this. Now I'm gonna go a little smaller. So we went very small, medium, large, extra large circles. Now we're gonna go back. And then we're gonna come right to here, small circles again. And now, yep, reverse. Let's go backwards. So if you're feeling some burning sensation in the shoulders and within the neck region and the shoulder girdle, it means you're doing a good job. I'm feeling it too. Just breathe it out. Do your best. A little bit bigger now. A little bit bigger, real big now. Just throw your arms through. Now what this does is it serves to open up your shoulder girdle. It also helps you to breathe a little more efficiently. When the lungs increase their capacity, you know, those little alveoli holding on to that nitrogen, right, the oxygen, it's going to expand. When that does, you doing this helps you to get more air into those lungs. More air in the lungs, more air gets cleaned into through the heart, goes out to the body again. We do some action, right? Come back down here. So far, head, neck, shoulders, upper back. So now let's just go ahead and take it to here, right? So this is known as biceps flexion. I'm gonna do 20 of these, three. I don't want you to flex hard at the top. I just want you to move your arms, that hinge joint that we know as the elbow, all right? We're just gonna flex, extend, flex, extend, flex, extend. That's it. Five more, one, two, three, four, five, turn your hands, elbows up, extend, one, two, three, I'll back up so you can see a little better, four, five, good job, good to see you made it, proud of you, it'd be real easy just to not watch the video, you know, just hang out, but just hanging out gets you the results that you want. Just hanging out, allow you to earn your results, take that journey, learning something about yourself, becoming the doer, one who does. That's doer, that's you, that's me, and at BKLT, that's what we do, that's how we do. Come back down, now, let's put our fist together. essential component of physical education, health, recreation, and dance. And as a physical educator and health teacher, one of my priorities is packaging these lessons so that they apply to all of you. You need to be able to do this. Shift your weight. Good. See if you can turn 90 degrees. Rotate 90 degrees. Move your feet. Rotate. 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 Back to the middle. Make 90 degree angles. Wrist rotations forward. If you're tired there, and you'd rather rest your arms against your torso, do that too. You're going to make complete circles with your wrists. Another dynamic stretch that ensures that our hands, especially you texters, let's make sure our hands, fingers, thumbs, wrists, and everything that corresponds to the lower arm is healthy, two at a time, forward. Notice the circles. Walk a little forward so you can see me a little better. If you really want to be here, and really take the time to accentuate the movement, it's almost like you're making food. Take a step back. Now from here, we're going to come back towards you. Now I'm doing it away from you, and you're going towards yourself. Just make believe you're grabbing air. And again, if you're tired, you can post up those elbows onto your torso, and then you have a comfortable platform in which to work. If you want more challenge, you can see here, your elbows are off the body. Back to you, two hands at a time now. Get that full wrist turn and see the flow, right? It's like a wrist symphonic dynamic stretch harmony. And I'm just hoping that you'll be able to do this easily and it will provide something that you can really use on the daily. And I know you're gonna know somebody who needs a little help with their wrists, they're a little hurt, something, who knows? Come this way, come down. And now there's something all of you know how to do. We've worked from head to right here, so now we're gonna march in place. Two, we're gonna lift these legs up. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, stand straight up. 10, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, pretty lonely out here, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 more. 1. So this is called form running. This is something that is outstanding for every person to do, not just athletes. We all do it in our own way. Okay, three more. 1, 2, 3. First aspect of form running, hip flexion, right? That's what we just did with the marching in place. You can also walk and actually physically move and do that. The next portion is to combine a thigh extension with that hip flexion. Hip flexion. Thigh extension from the side. You can do this in place too. It would be a 1, 2, just gonna curl your leg, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I'll show you 9, 10, 8, 9, 10. Next exercise you wanna work on is you wanna stand feet shoulder width apart. You wanna hip flex, rotate out, step, step. You wanna hip, rotate out, step, step. Hip, rotate out, step, step. Hip, rotate out, step, step. recommending you holding your hip so you can feel the rotation take place. That way you know what's optimal and what is not. So let's go back the other way. Hip, rotate out, step, step. Flexion, rotate your hip, step, step. Flexion, rotate your hip, step, step. Hip flexion, rotate your hip, step, step. Show you from the other side. So left side for me, flex, rotate. Flex, rotate. Make sure when you hip flex, you come up straight. And then rotate only as far as the hip allows. Up, allows, down. One more. Straight, rotate, down. Going back to the right. Up, out, down. Up, straight, rotate, down. Three more. Up, rotate, down. Up. Down, up, rotate, back. Those are the first four running exercises. Hip flexion. When you have that lateral left, that lateral right. Looking at it from the center, lateral left, come up straight, rotate out, down, repeat. Rotate lateral right, which is your left. Straight, rotate, down. Repeat, straight, rotate, down. Take your time. This can't be done effectively fast. A lot of the skills that are necessary for physical education, recreation, and dance are perfected slowly. That way, when participants want to do them quicker, during competition, or moments of self-reflection, practice, competition, it can go quicker without mistake. Okay. Last exercise that we have here are a bicep flexion of the leg, so it requires some balance. 7, 8, 9, 10. This way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Step back so you can see me. Hips, knees, feet, one straight line, standing straight up, posture's really good, breathe in, breathe out, slight bend in the knees now, raise up onto the toes, hold, 1, 2, 3, down, raise, 1, 2, 3, down, raise, 1, 2, 3, down, now you got the rhythm, let's just do it, we're going to rock a little bit, on the toes, down, rock on the heels, on the toes, down, rock on the heels. Keep that up. I want you to keep it up. I'm going to show you the side angle so you can see what my body weight's doing, because I don't know if you can catch it from the front angle. You'll actually see me rock back a little bit right here. See that? And the toes go up. I want you to work that weight transfer and see if you can feel the point at which if you go a little more, it'd be too much. And then master the art of staying in between what's too much and what's too little. All right, ooh, really starting to work good in there. Oh yeah, good job. We'll come back to the center. Keep it up, keep going, you have 10 more seconds. Good. 3, 2, 1. Excellent job, everybody. This is a really fine example of a full head to toe dynamic workout routine. Now, it's a dynamic stretch that's also a workout when it's done for a long period of time. Do this twice, you definitely have a workout. I have other videos that I've included that you'll see on Google site, my classroom. Physical meditation in the forest, a chi or energy building warm up, and I also give you the option to learn Wing Chun Kung Fu, which is, if many of you know of Bruce Lee, famous movie star and martial artist, it's the style that he learned in Foshan, China and brought to America. It's not required, but I know many arts, that's one I know, and I decided to share it with you virtually, so you'd have the option, should you be interested. Watch this video, do this video, try to do it twice a day, and if you can, watch the other videos, Qi or energy building, the Wing Chun Kung Fu, and also the other dynamic warm-up video in the forest, and you'll have a really good platform. Week by week, there'll be more videos. Pay attention to that weekly diary, log in your workouts, and make sure you drop me a line if there's anything you wish to understand a little better. Have a nice day, everybody.